In this video today, I am going to show you how tax brackets work and in a way that you'll be able to understand no matter where you're at with your tax knowledge. Let's get it. Welcome back, everyone. My name's Nate, and I'm here to help you master your money. So there are many common misconceptions out there when it comes to how taxes work. And some people are even scared to get raises because they're worried their taxes will go up significantly, which fortunately for you guys is not the case at all. And so instead of thinking about tax brackets as brackets, we're gonna look at them a little differently. And to do that, I need to adjust the camera real quick to show you guys how that's all gonna work. But before I do that, something very important you guys need to know about before I get going is gonna be the need. There's a significant need out there of unsmashed like buttons. And so if you could, for just one like smash, a button could get smashed for the likes, for the YouTube algorithm, of course. So please smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you have not already, get your 4 free socks down in the description from Webull. They're offering those for the next couple weeks here. If you deposit $100 in their platform, they'll give you 4 free socks. 2 of those can be valued up to $1,600. So get those there. And with that out of the way, let's get going. Welcome back, guys. So I'm today gonna explain how tax brackets actually work. There's a lot of confusion out there about that, but I'm gonna describe to you how you can take the money that you're currently earning, how it's taxed, and understand really what happens when you get a raise. There's a lot of confusion about raises and possibly being pushed into a new tax bracket. And I'm gonna break that down very simply today. So for this example, let's say that you make $40,000 currently. This is not actually $40,000 and it's not real money. This is fake play money, just to show you guys how this works. So let's say you have an income currently before taxes of $40,000, and this would put you squarely at the top end of the 22% tax bracket. Now, some people are scared in this position to get raises, and the reason is they think that if they make a few hundred dollars more per month, say just $200 more, this would push them into the new tax bracket, which is at 24%, which would cost them quite a bit more money per year on their taxes. But that is not the case. Instead of thinking of taxes as being in a bracket, it's better to help think of it as being a bucket. Each of the buckets are taxed at a certain rate, and that bucket can only hold so much money. And once that bucket is full, income gets delegated to the next bucket. So if we're to understand how tax brackets actually work, we're gonna start with a higher number just so you all can see how things function at higher tax levels. And also going forward in this example, we're gonna assume a salary of $100,000 just for an example. So with a $100,000 per year income, your top end tax bracket, which means the absolute last tax bracket you're gonna be affected by is going to be the tax bracket at 24%. So with the way that people currently understand their taxes, many are afraid to get a raise because they're worried it's going to push them into a new tax bracket, and therefore all of their income will now be taxed at a much higher rate. So for example, let's say someone with an income of, $40,000 is getting offered a promotion and a raise, which is gonna increase their income by $500. Now, this is gonna push their top end tax bracket from being at 12% to being taxed at 22%. Now that 10% jump is very significant, and some people are afraid of a small raise because they're worried all of their income is going to be taxed at that new rate, which for the record is not how that works. For this example going forward, we're gonna assume an income of $100,000 per year before taxes, just so I can show you how things work at various levels. Instead of thinking about the tax schedule like a bracket, think about it more as a bucket. And these buckets vary widely in size from small to large. And each of these buckets are taxed at a different rate. And so the way things work is you start at the very bottom and you get taxed at a low rate. And at the beginning of the year, your taxes start here. This is the same for everybody. And the first $9,875 that you make is taxed at 10%. Up next is the 12% tax bracket. And so for all income that you earn after $9,876 up until $40,125, that will all be taxed at 12%. But that does not mean that this money you earn down here, the money that was up to $9,875, that does not get taxed at 12% as well. That stays taxed at just 10%. So starting at $40,126 up until $85,525 of income, in this range here, you'll be taxed at 22%. But again, just because you're taxed at 22% here, that does not mean your other income down here gets taxed at that rate as well. And so down here with the last tax bracket we have, this one is going to be at 24%, but this is only going to be applied to income starting at $85,526 up to $163,300. Now, for this example, we only have $14,475 in this pile here that is being taxed at 24%. We have this amount here that is being taxed at 22%. This amount here being taxed at 12%, and this amount here being taxed at 10%. Now, these buckets are all taxed differently, but there are things that can help save you money on taxes. So just so you understand how this works, we're gonna start out down here, and at this rate, we're taxed at 10%. So I'm taking 10% of our money and putting it down here for taxes. In our 12% tax bracket, we're gonna be owing $3,629.88 in tax. So to round up, we're using four bills as an example for how much we owe in tax. Moving on to the 22% tax bracket, we're gonna be taxed at a higher rate. And so even though we had similar amounts in this 22% bracket and the 12% bracket, we owe a lot more money on this amount here. So we're gonna go ahead and take out 10 bills because that's how much tax we're gonna owe. It's gonna be just under $10,000. And the total actually comes to $9,987.78. So on this bucket, we'll be taxed almost $10,000. I'm gonna sit this out here. And in the 24% tax bracket, we're gonna owe almost $3,500 in tax. So we're gonna go ahead and put this out here. And then we're gonna do one of these. And there we go. So without anything else combined or considered with this, we would owe $18,778 in tax in total. Now that's assuming we don't do anything about it and that's how much tax we owe and we had no money taken out of our check or anything like that. But there's something that we can do to go ahead and decrease our taxable liability. Now there is a bucket we can put money into that will not be taxed. And this is going to be called your deductions bucket. Now there's certain rules on this, but essentially if you were to go ahead and contribute money to a retirement account, money into an HSA, or if you were to run a business that had a loss in the year you're filing taxes, you could potentially protect some of your income from being taxed. Hold on, hit the pause button for a second. This is the end of part one of this video. I hope you guys liked it. And if you did, I know you'll be back for part two, which will come out in a week or so. You'll see, it'll be good, but it'll answer a lot of your questions that you have related to taxes. And you'll get to see my beautiful face once more. So stick around to see that. It'll be great. It will be worth it. With that said, I'll see you guys next week. Bye.